Have you ever watched a video or listened to a podcast and it was obvious they just didn't edit it? Like, you can hear all of the noises and see all of the mistakes? Editing your course videos is an important step in providing a great experience for your students. In this video, I'll teach you how to edit your videos with the simple and free video editing app, iMovie. Let's get into it. Hello creators, I'm Ben Tolson from Podia, where we empower creators like you to make a living doing what you love. iMovie is a great video editing tool if you're just starting out and comes free with iPhone, iPad, and Mac devices. Today's video is going to focus on editing in this app on a Mac, but if you have Windows, there are a couple of iMovie alternatives you can use. iMovie is free to download as a trial, and like iMovie, features a simple user interface. After the trial period, you can purchase the basic version for about $39. You can find it at iMovie.com. HitFilm Express is 100% free. No trial period, they just give it to you. It's comparable to more powerful programs like Final Cut Pro and Premiere Pro. You can download HitFilm Express at fxhome.com/hitfilm-express. Now, let's get into iMovie. First, you want to find or download iMovie. It comes pre-installed on most devices, and to check for it, you can either type Command Spacebar and type iMovie, or you can navigate to your Applications folder in Finder and search for it there. If you plan to use iMovie quite a bit, I recommend moving it to your dock. If you don't have it already, you can download it at apple.com/iMovie or from the App Store. When you first open iMovie, click on the big plus sign above Create New and select Movie. I'm going to give you a quick tour of what you'll see on the next screen. Here we have three basic sections: Media Libraries, where you can navigate and add various types of media, a Preview Monitor, where you can see a preview of your video, and the Timeline, where you'll be editing your video. In this video, we won't get into each of the individual features and tools, but only touch on what we need for editing and saving your lesson video. Adding your footage. To add your footage, you can either click on the Import Media button and find your file, or you can drag your file directly into the timeline from the Finder window. If you use the Import Media button, just be sure to drag your clip down into the timeline. I'm going to use a clip from one of our Podia videos as an example. Before moving on to the next step, you'll want to click Settings at the upper right of the timeline and make sure Show Waveforms is checked. You can zoom in and out of your timeline with Command Plus or Minus. Zooming in will make it easier to make cuts, and zooming out will make it easier to navigate to different sections of your video. Editing your footage. The first thing we'll do is right-click the clip in your timeline and select Add Cross Dissolve. This will add a fade transition to the beginning and to the end of your video. The previous video in this series covered recording your lesson slides, and I encouraged you to clap whenever you made a mistake so it would be easy to find during the editing process. If you've done that, you should be able to see a spike in your audio waveform and can navigate to those points in your clip. To edit out your mistake, click the point on the clip just after the clap and type Command B. This will split the clip. Now, bring the cursor to the edge of the clip and you should see a vertical line with an arrow pointing away on either side. If you click, you can drag that clip to just before the beginning of the bad take. The remaining clips will automatically join together and make a jump cut. That's a jump from one clip to the next with no transition. If you haven't used the clap method, or if you just want to watch through the whole thing and edit as you go, you can follow the same process. You may want to do this anyway so you can remove any unwanted pauses or excessive dead air. Final review and saving your video. Once you're done editing, you can watch your video from the beginning by hitting the backslash key. Watch through to make sure you haven't missed any edits. If all looks good, it's time to save your video. Click the export icon at the top right of your screen and select File, or go to File, Share, and select File. From here, you can edit the title, add a video description, and even add tags. You should title your videos with the name of your lesson. For the other settings, I recommend the following: Resolution, 1080p. Unless your course is meant to be viewed on a larger screen, then you might want to export it in 4K. For quality, choose High Quality, and for compression, choose Better Quality. Then click Next. Now you're going to choose where you want to save your video file. If you don't see your folder, click the down arrow so you can navigate to the module folder that corresponds with your lesson and click Save. you'll see a circle appear in the upper right hand of your screen that will show you the saved progress of your video. iMovie will notify you once your video is finished rendering. And you're done, at least with this video. In the future, we'll do a more in-depth look at the various tools and features in iMovie, but this should at least help you get started. The next and final video in the series will walk you through how to publish and sell your online course. I want to hear from you. What video editing software do you prefer and why? Let me know in the comments. If you found this video helpful and you want more content like this, subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any future videos. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.